The South Carolina State House, it took an honor guard just 36 seconds to lower a symbol that has divided this nation for a century and a half. The applause was thunderous and sustained. Look at the crowd. After 54 years, the Confederate battle flag was brought down from the site for the very last time. It was a swift and dramatic turn in history, born of the racist murders of 9 members of a black church in Charleston less than a month ago by a man who embraced that flag. Tonight, we have 2 reports.
Workers removing the Johnny Reb statue this morning that sat on top of an 80-foot Confederate monument in downtown Norfolk, Virginia. The mayor says the statue will be relocated out of concern for public safety. Protesters across America are tearing down and damaging memorials that they say honors racist figures from history. Chip Reed is in Richmond, another Virginia city where Confederate monuments are under attack. Chip, good morning to you. I know this has been an issue there for years.
Oh, for a very long time. Of course, Richmond was the capital of the Confederacy. So there are monuments like this one. This one is to Robert E. Lee all over this town. Politicians have spent years talking about doing something about it, maybe bringing them down, putting them in a museum, or maybe just adding some context. But this week, protesters said, "We are tired of waiting."
Richmond residents celebrated Thursday at the graffiti-covered and long controversial statue of Confederate General Robert E. Lee.
All that down below is hundreds of years in the making. And all the emotion and all the energy and all the passion that created that, it'd be a shame to wipe that away.
Very empowering, not just for black people, but white people as well who wants change. You know what I mean?
That call for change has hit the city's monuments hard, with protesters bringing down the statue of Jefferson Davis, the president of the Confederacy, and landing Christopher Columbus in a local lake. Protesters took action across the country, tearing down memorials to the country's racist history, leading some officials to...
Obstructions. My view was obstructed despite the flag being removed. The monument still stand with pride, laughing, mocking our attempt to reclaim our identity as superior beings. We thought the war would end it all. The president ever tended to give us freedom. Our victory from the Union was only so the succession would not ruin his legacy. Unrealistic expectations, we would be seen as equals. We never asked for a seat at the table. We had our own table, snatched away, commanded we serve, build and fight for a right at a table we constructed, deemed our complexion darkness when our melanin shines brighter than any star, our hue impenetrable, rebirth, reborn. We have weathered the storm through every period and era of struggle, slavery, Confederacy, Reconstruction, Hamburg Massacre, segregation. Impossible, unstoppable, unpopular until profitable, robbed and misappropriated, mimicked and manipulated. Thank God that some of us are awakened and never were sleeping. We are aware that our imminence has existed since the beginning of time. The same God you claim is also ours, mine. had us all in mind, yet we are separated because some of you continue to perpetuate a system rooted in hate. Monuments obstructing my view of justice, blocking anti-lynching laws, indignantly and violently opposing our rights to vote. We will continue to proclaim, declare, and demand change must and will take place. The removal of the flag wasn't enough. Monument statues of hate have been grounded in other states. We must join the rally cry, emerging as a new identity of this country, who we can actually say for some loves all its citizens. We can't not just make it convenient by chatting Team USA during the Olympics. I really can't pledge allegiance because we were never considered as one. I can no longer say and lie that this country was made for you and me when I was forced to be here. We are aware of your intentions were never to accept our presence as nothing more than subservient. Domination was the only language you spoke. So the day will come, you'll be forced to recognize the truth. We were always on your level, if not higher. Never once did we seek revenge, only seeking to tear out the pages of your textbooks. Because the same people who have been tenacious, courageous, strengthened while rising above the false teachings, our lives never mattered, our hope will never shattered. Indestructible in the midst of seeing our kings and queens swing from trees, fleeing burning towns we built. Yes, our faith is bulletproof despite the unaccounted for and wrong death lawsuits. The message is clear that we ain't hearing nothing that doesn't esteem our rights to freedom. Dismantle the trophies of hate. Exhume the sacred ground of bigotry.